Hello and welcome, my dear third standard little champs. How have you been? This is Rohan sir from Mehdi English Medium School welcoming all my dear third standard boys and girls once again in the science lecture. Students, I hope that boys and girls, you are working hard at your home for your studies. Along with that, I hope that girls might be helping their mother or grandmother in the kitchen. Boys might be helping their father or elder brothers or sisters in many things at their home, and along with that you might also be studying. So I hope that you are maintaining your work, your homework, your book related work equally in your home. As you are now studying in your home, I hope that you will be helpful to everyone around you. Students, you know that the revision time is going on. We have been revising different topics with different theory part containing different keywords and many more details which we have not studied in from the textbook theory part. So I hope that you are observing the lecture very carefully, because now in your WhatsApp group, new type of homework will be given to you. You will have to wait for it, and the system how to submit the homework will also be different. So I hope that you all will respond to it, and please keep sending new thoughts and ideas so that I can share it here with your name in the lectures, so that I can spread those good ideas amongst your friends. Welcome once again in the science lecture. You must be wondering, what are we going to do? We will start with chapter number 10, revision. Obviously, explanation revision will be done with the extra theory from the different materials I have, along with the textbook theory part, which you might have forgotten little bit. So it is a kind of a good recall to the chapter. Why am I sending you the explanation video again for the revision? Always is, once you understand the concept, you remember the concept, you don't anymore have to mug up the objectives at least, right? So this is the reason, and this is how useful it is. So I hope that whenever the revision lectures are going on, you do not take it lightly. It is the thing which is the most important one. So please take it very seriously, and along with that, at the same time, you can even enjoy the lecture. So this is what my intention is. Now let's get started. If you have the textbook, open page number 98. Yes, I know that the extra theory part which I'm going to display, you will not be having that. At least when I display the textbook, you will be having that. You can compare the extra theory part along with the topics which are there in the textbook. So pencil, your textbook, you can keep it with you. I'll give you a couple of seconds to get ready. Please make sure while you are watching the lecture, your eyes, your brain, your ears, you should give it for the 30 minutes to me. No, I'm not asking you to cut the eyes and ears and give it to me. You should apply it here in the lecture. This is what I mean to say. So let us get started now. I suppose you should be ready now. You can even keep your water bottles with you, as if you are sitting in the classroom, you will really enjoy it. So chapter number 10, measurements. We have learned many a things, starting with the meaning of measurement, right? You might have heard many a times and at many places, and yes, now 90% of you might be familiar with this word, because I have already explained this chapter. So what is measurement? What are you going to learn? So learning objectives are these many. You will learn what does measuring tells us, what is the use of it. Then measuring of length, weight, capacity, time and temperature. Every these things are measured with the different ways, different instruments. So what is measurement? Actually, measuring tells us the specific size of something. I repeat, measuring tells us specific size of something by measuring something, we can find out how big it is, how small it is, how long, short it is, how much amount, how light and heavy it is. So every different aspect of every different things could be found out by measuring that thing in the different ways. So you know that measuring in the ancient times during our forefathers' time when they were young, we measure the length to find out how long something is. They used to use their body parts. They did not had any measuring kind of facility or machine. So one of the oldest units of length measurement used in an ancient world was the cubit. Yes, it is truth. A cubit is the length of the arm from the tip of the finger to the elbow. Here you can clearly see that the arrow shows this much part of the hand is the cubit. When they used this much part of the hand, they called it cubit measurement, because nowadays you have ruler. Similarly, rulers were not available. During those days, they were using cubit. This could then be subdivided into shorter units like the foot, hand or finger. You can see they could even measure the small units using their just palms, which can be called as the hand span. From thumb till the last finger, this is how they used to measure. So the cubit could vary due to the different sizes of people. Now, children, your size of hand will be different. My size of the hand will be different. Your father's hand, your brother's hand might be different in the sizes. Just imagine if we are given the task to measure something. Your measurement will be different because your this much size is different of the hand. Mine is different. Your brother's hand is different in the size. So this was not giving the perfect measurement. And hand span and foot span were also used for measuring length. A hand span is the distance from the tip of the thumb to the tip of the little finger on your outstretched hand. Foot span involves the measurement of the length by the size of the foot. Till the date we use 1 foot, 2 feet, 3 feet, correct? But now the unit of measurements are fixed. It does not change from person to person because now no more body parts are used. So measuring today comparatively, today these ancient units are considered as non-standard units of measuring length. This is because these units vary from person to person. Vary means, this is not V-E-R-Y, this is V-A-R-Y, that means changes. So the measurement which you do with your hands and legs obviously changes from one person to another person, because one person will be having different length. Say for an example, live example, when you take your slippers, your shoes, the size is different from your brother's or father's shoes. You might be wearing 3 or 4 number, your brothers or your parents might be wearing 9 or 10 number, 11 number. So this is because the sizes of the legs and hands are different. So when you measure it with your body parts are different of the different person. So the measurement changes from one person to another person. And this is the reason why they are called non-standard units. They don't give the standard measurement, no fixed measurement. So, let us move on to the concept of measuring length. Today we use the tools such as ruler and measuring tapes to measure the length of the things. Yes, you might have seen these kind of rulers you might be using in your school. These kind of measuring tapes you might have seen in the tailor's shop when they take the measurement of your shoulder, your waist, your hand, your, you know, sleeves. They take the measurement to stitch the clothes according to your height and your body. So nowadays, these kind of instruments are used to measure the length. See, we are just on the topic measuring the length first. So this is what we are understanding. Ruler we use, right? You use ruler in which way? In your mathematics, right? So here there are different two units when you are talking about measurement of length: meter and centimeter. Let us understand what are they. I should say let us re-understand, let us revise, because this is what we have already understood, and we have done whole lot of activities related to this topic. So let us understand this again. I hope that you are all ready and all set to recall the concept of meter, centimeter, eventually measurement of length. Meter, which is denoted as small m, is the standard unit of length. A unit that does not change is called a standard unit. Now you know what is non-standard unit. Our hands and legs are non-standard. It changes, right, in the size. Standard unit is it has a fixed size. Longer lengths are measured in the meters, while the shorter lengths are measured in the centimeters, for which we use this kind of scales. In our books, measurements are limited where we use our centimeter scale, but when we are measuring the clothes, measuring the building, we use meter as the unit. I hope you have understood this concept. Now in your book, it was the fact file was given in your book on page number 99 of your textbook, if you are having, that the tallest building in the world is in the Dubai, namely Burj Al Khalifa. It is about 829.8 meters high. I repeat, 829.8 meters high. Building is very tall. It is long measurement. That's why it is measured in the meters, not centimeters. I hope this concept is clear now. Let's move to the next page where we are going to see measuring weight. First of all, these are the instruments which you 99.99% of you might have seen. Yes or no? These are very commonly seen in any town or in any city. So, measuring weight. Common balance and weights and electronic balance are devices that are used to measure the weight. Now, what is weight, right? So here it is actually the mass. Mass tells us the amount of material object contains. So kilograms and grams are common units of measuring the weight. Heavy objects are measured in kilograms, and the light object are measured in grams. Yes, so here you might have seen these kind of machines in the vegetable shops. Yes, nowadays vegetable vendors are also using electronic machine, but in the ancient times these kind of machines were used, and they were having different measurements, different stones with them. They kept vegetables on one side, stones on the other side, so that equally when it comes, when they become equal, they come to know that this is the weight of vegetable or fruit. Till the date, you can go to vegetable vendors, they will show you these kind of machines. I will insist you to see these kind of machines in the real life. You will really enjoy it and you will be able to understand it practically. So this is what you should know, that kilograms and grams are there. The heaviest or the heavier objects are measured in kilogram. The lighter objects are measured in grams. Now if I say I need to measure the mass of the rice, it can be measured in the grams and kilograms both. Depends on how much quantity are we applying, right? Then the gold chain, these all things are the light, or I should say lighter things, measured in the grams as well. But now if I say I want so many potatoes, or a sack of potato is there. So sack of potato is obviously going to be very heavy. It can't be measured in grams. It will be measured in the kilograms, right? So let's move further to measuring liquids. Now you will say, sir, how can we measure the liquids? I will ask you the question, why can't we? Everyone might be seeing now, as you are at home in the morning, you might be seeing milkmen coming with the milk either in the polythene, or they are pouring the milk in the container, in the bowl you are giving them. So they pour the milk, they give you the milk, they give you the milk in the polythene bag, in the plastic bag. They are having proper measurement. They can't just give you the milk as per your requirement. They will charge as per the measurement. So how is it measured? This is the question. Yes, milk is liquid. So how are the liquids measured? Let us understand. So measuring cups are used to measure the liquid. Can you see here different cups are used? Measuring cups are made of clear glass or plastic. Why is it so? You can see liquids poured inside. You can easily see that how much liquid is there. You can easily measure that. That is why it is made up of pure transparent glass or plastic, so that you can see on both the sides clearly. Hence you can measure it. They have markings on the outside of a handle and the spout for easy pouring. So you can see here the markings are there, 10 liter, 15 liter, 20 liter. This way markings are there. So as soon as you pour any liquid, you can easily see the measurement. And they are having the handles, so you can hold it and you can just serve it or pour whatever liquid is there inside. So here again the units are liter and milliliter. The quantity of the liquid that a container such as bucket, mug or jug can hold is referred to as its capacity. Liters are used to measure the bigger units. Milliliters are used to measure the smaller units. Now, moving on to measurement of time. What is time? Let me ask you. What according to you is time? Sometimes we say we have very less time. We have 5 minutes, we have 10 minutes, right? So this is the time, correct? Or we can say we have 1 day or 2 days, we have few months. So time can be referred to as a seconds, as the minutes. We can refer to as an hours, days or months and years as well. So this is called time. How can we measure that? Clocks and watches tells us the time. Very obvious. Now, wherever you are sitting, just move your head around. Can you see the wall clock on the wall? What is the time right now? See, it gives you the information what the time is. These devices measure the time in hours, minutes and seconds. Watches or clocks cannot measure the time in day or month. Yes, nowadays digital clocks are available, which shows you the time, which shows you the day and the date, which even shows you the temperature. That's different thing. But general wall clocks or watches cannot show more than hours, minutes or seconds. Here, one extra information is given for you to know and you to understand. You can even Google it later. A sundial is the tool that uses the position of the sun to measure the time. Yes, students, during the ancient days, my grandmother used to tell me that when his father was young, they did not had any watch or anything. They used to see the shadow and they used to easily understand what is the time. So sharp their brain was. Yes, they were trained accordingly, because during those days, no wall clock, no watches, nothing was there. Forget about the mobile. So sundial is also a kind of device later was developed to see the time by the help of sun. You can see here basic information is given, very basic information, that 1 hour equals to 60 minutes, right? 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. So this is what it is. Now 60 means the minute hand is different, the hour hand is different, the second hand is different, seconds hand, which shows the second minute and hour respectively. So keep observing the wall clock, keep observing the watches to understand the time. Next is measuring temperature. What is temperature? Temperature is a degree of hotness or coldness. It shows how hot or how cold the climate is. That is the temperature. How many degrees Celsius or Fahrenheit sometimes we use. We use thermometer to measure the temperature. You must have seen your parents or doctor uses a thermometer to measure the fever. Yes, this you all might have seen when you don't feel good, when you are feeling uneasy. Your parents who are knowledgeable, they might be having this thermometer, they measure the temperature. Especially this was useful in the corona days, right? Doctors surely have this to measure how much temperature, how much fever patient has or have. So temperature is measured on the centigrade scale. Here in the thermometer, you must have seen thermometer, either doctor keeps it under the arm or the doctor keeps it under the tongue to measure it at least for 1.5 or 2 minutes, so that it can easily show how much temperature or how much fever a patient has. Now, this is the end of our extra theory from the extra material. I hope you have recollected a whole lot of topic and you are enjoying the different measurements of length, time, mass, that is weight, yes, the length. So different measurements were used to learn here. Now the summary points are: measuring tells us the specific size of something. Obviously, now if you need to know the specific size, weight or anything of something, you need to measure that. Cubit, hand span and foot span are non-standard unit of measurement. Why they are the non-standard unit? Because like I said, everyone's hands and legs and feet sizes are different. That's why when you measure it with your feet is different from what I measure with my feet. Meter, kilogram and liter are standard units of measuring length, weight and capacity respectively. That is meter measuring length, kilogram measuring weight and liter used for measuring the capacity of the particular container used for measuring the liquids. Time is measured in hours, minutes and seconds. In particularly, it can also be measured in the days and years or months. But that is not for the clock or watch, that we can measure with the calendar. Temperature is measured on the centigrade scale. Rulers, common balances, weights, electronic balances, measuring cups, clocks, watches and thermometer are the devices or the tools used for measuring. So these are the measuring units, measuring devices, instruments which you might be using in your regular life. You use scale, you use ruler in your school for mathematics. You might be using your watch to measure the time, how much time long the period is, when the lecture is going to change. You must be using measuring weight for measuring the different things, like even your weight, which is measured in the kilograms. So these are very useful devices with having the standard unit of measurement, which does not change. This is what the main thing is. Now you have to repeat these points with me. Like I said, we will learn new keywords and new meanings. So please repeat this with me loudly, clearly, girls and boys. Capacity, the quantity of liquid that a container can hold. Okay, I hope you were repeating it with me. Cubit, the length of the arm from the tip of the finger to the elbow. Hand span, the distance from the tip of the thumb to the tip of a little finger on your outstretched hand. I know many of you might be feeling difficulty in speaking, pronouncing this word, outstretched. Next is length. Measurement that tells us how long something is. Second last is standard unit. A unit that does not change. Thermometer, instrument used to measure the temperature. So this is the end of our today's session. I hope you enjoyed, revised and recollected, recalled all the points which you might have forgotten. With this, I end my today's lecture here. Have a nice day. Stay safe. Goodbye.